Hello and welcome to the class. So today's topic is Mathematics Paper 2 extended for the IGCSE and paper code is 0580 October-November 2019. So let's start with the questions, and in case of any doubt then you can ask your questions in the comment section. So starting with the first questions, work out the 5% of the $25. So 5%, so 5 upon 100 into 25. So simply what we can do, we can cancel 25 into 1 and 25 into 4. So it is like 5 upon 4. If I'm going to divide this one, so I will get 1.25. So this is $1.25. So this is how we can find the first question answer. Now moving to the next one. Factorize this one. So what is common for these two? So P, I can see P is common. Other than P, they don't have any common factor. I can take common P. So answer is 5 plus T. So final answer we can write here 5 plus t inside the bracket, and then there is b. Moving to the next question, so you have to calculate the value and write into the two significant figure. So we'll use calculator here in this case and we'll write the final answer. Okay, so our answer is like, if I'm going to calculate this one, 16.379 minus 0.879 divided by 4.2 into 1.241. So our answer is 4.57980, like this. So what we can write here, we can write here, we need to write into the first two. Like this we can write, because 4.58, if I wanted to write for the two decimal, they're asking for the two significant figure. So in this case 4.6, because the two significant figure is 4.6, so our answer will be 4.6 for the two significant figure. Now moving to the next question, which is like quite easy question. Write this one 15,016 words. So it's simple, we have to write like FIF 15,060. So in standard form is like, it should be between 1 to 9 whenever we write the number. So it should be like, we can write here 1.5060 into 10 raised to power. Now how many points we jump? 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's a team. This is 10 raised to power 4. So this is like, we can write here 1.506 into 10 raised to power 4. You can neglect this part 0. Okay, now simplify the algebraic terms. So we know simplification is like, we have to add or subtract the like terms. Here we can see 5c and 2c, so we can write here 3c. Now minus d and minus 3d, so we can write here, we can add these together, so we'll write here 4d. So our final answer we can write here 3c minus 4d. Okay, so these are quite easy questions. Now moving to the question number 6. So question number 6, solve, that means find the value of x. So what I will do here, I will just move this x over here. So I will write here x minus 2 is equals to 3 into 3. Now x minus 2 is equals to 9. X is equals to 9 plus 2, so x is equals to 11. So in this case I will write here 11. So 11 is our final answer. Now simplification, so this is like indices. So we know a raised to power m into a raised to power n is equals to, we can write a raised to power m plus n. So first of all we need to multiply number with number, so 2 into 3 is 6. Now x raised to power, will add these two as per this, we'll use this one. So 6 x raised to power 5, so our answer will be 6 x raised to power 5. Okay, now question number 8, if you see. So without using a calculator, we have to find out the value of this one. So this is like 5 upon 16 is fine, but this is in mixed fraction. 1 over 17, we can write here 1 into 7 plus 1 upon 7. So this is what, 7 plus 1, 8 upon 7. So I will write here into 8 upon 7. This is improper fractions. We convert it from the mixed fraction. Now 8 into 1, 8 into 2. So we can write here 5 upon 14 is the simplest form. Why? Because there is no common factor. for them. Now moving to the question, next question, question number 9. So question number 9 is based on the simple interest. So formula for the SI is equals to principal into rate of interest into time upon 100. Okay, so simple interest in this case like is not given, but principal is given. Oh sorry, interest is also given, 90. So SI is equals to 90, principal is equals to 600, rate of interest is not given, so R is there, and time is 10 years. So all the values if you are going to substitute, then what will happen? It is equals to 90, principal is 600, rate of interest is R, time is T, so this is what, 10 upon 100, right? So we can cancel these two, and this is like 90 upon 10, so 90 upon, sorry, 60, 6 into 10 is 60, so is equals to R. I can cancel these two, 3 upon 2, so R is equals to 1.5%, or you can write 1 point, rate of interest is 1.5%. Okay, so this is like how we can calculate the rate of interest. Now moving to the next question. So this is what simplification, again this is what indices. So we know rule, if a raised to power m raised to power n, we can write a raised to power m into n. Another is if a raised to power minus n, we can write 1 upon a raised to power n, that means the reciprocal. So first we'll use this one. So reciprocal, take the reciprocal, so I will write 8 upon x raised to power 3, 4 upon 3. Now this is what positive when we take the reciprocal. Now we can write 2 upon x raised to power whole cube. So 2 cube is 8 and x cube was already x cube, 4 raised to power 3. Now we will multiply this and this got cancelled. So 2 raised to power 4 and x raised to power 4. 2 raised to power 4 is 16, x raised to power 4 is this. So we will write here 16 upon x raised to power 4 is our final answer. Or if you want, you can simplify and write in terms of like negative also, x raised to power minus 4. Okay, now we have to rearrange, make the subject and rearrange the formula and find out the value of R. Write R in terms of P and Pi. So we know R is common for these two. We will write it, P is equals to R 2 plus Pi. Now this is in multiplication, we will shift here. So R is equals to, it will go in division, 2 plus Pi. So simply what we can write, R is equals to P upon 2 plus Pi is our answer. Okay, now moving to the next question, is like the side of the square is this one, 15.1, correct to the one decimal, upper bound. So whenever they ask you whatever the given thing, like it is one decimal, so what will go area of, if area of square, if I'm going to write area of square is equals to side square, in this case like upper bound, so we'll add 0.05 and then we'll make it square. This is side square. So answer will be like 15 point, sorry, we'll write here 15 point, this is 15.15 whole square. If I'm going to use calculator, 15.15 square, so 229.5225 is the final answer. Okay, so this is the answer we can write. Okay, now moving to the next question, find the area of a triangle. So area of a triangle, if suppose this is a triangle and this angle is A, sorry, theta, this is A and this is B. So area of triangle is equals to half AB sine theta. So in this case, like angle included is 39, so half A is 11, B is 13 into sine 39. Okay, so we can multiply 11 into 13 divide by 2 is 71.5 into sine 39. So sine 39 is 0.629. So I'm going to multiply into 1, sorry, into 71.5, 71.5. So final answer is 44.99. Or we can write here 45. So area of the triangle is 45 centimeters square. So this is our answer. So area of the triangle is always half AB sine theta, where A and B are the side and theta is the included angle between them. Now this is what mapping thing. So mapping thing is like map scale to 1. So this is, you can write here map, and this is what actually map is like 1. This is what 10 followed by the 6 zeros. So 10 followed by 6 zeros, right? And on the map the area is given. Now this is what side is given, right? This is length part is given, and this is like, so what we will do it, so we'll square it. So we'll square here and we'll square here. So can we write like this, 10 followed by or 1 into how many zeros? So you can see 1 2 3 6. So 10 raised to power 7 raised to power 2, or we can have 10 raised to power 14. Now area is this. And actual area is like on the map, the area of this one is, this is in 4.9 centimeter square. And what will be the area in actual, in square kilometer? Okay, so now this is in centimeter, so we have to convert into the meter. So how we can convert? So we know 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter, or we can write 1 centimeter is equals to 1 upon 100 meter. And if I wanted to convert in kilometers, I will write here 100 into here 1000, because 1 kilometer is equals to 1000 meter. Kilometer. So this is like 3 plus 2, 5, 0. So 10 raised to power minus 5 kilometer. So if there is a square, like 1 centimeter square, then we can write 10 raised to power minus 10, because kilometer. So this is like, we can write here 10 raised to power minus 10. Okay, now it's done. So we'll cross multiply in order to get in square kilometer. This multiply with this. So x is equals to 4.9 into 10 raised to power minus 10 into 10 raised to power 14. Now we can write 4.9 into 10 raised to power minus 10 plus 4 will be 4. So 4.9 into 10 raised to power 4, or we can write 49. This is standard form. If you want, you can write in decimal 1 2 3. So it's like 49,000 kilometer square. So this is like how we perform conversion and find out the value. Moving to the next question, question number 15. So question number, y is inversely proportional to x square. That means y is inversely proportional to x square. Or if I write like this, k, if equals to sign, I have to multiply with the proportionality constant, which is k. Now when x is 2, when x is 2, y is, sorry, when x is 4, y is 2. X is 4, y is 2. So y is 2, x is 4. So k is equals to 2 into 16, k is equals to 32. Now we have proportionality constant. We can find the value of y. Y is equals to k upon x square. K is 32. X is 1 by 2 whole square. So 32. This is 1 upon 4. It will go upside. So 4 into 2, 128. So answer is 128. Okay. So this is like how we can find out the value of this one. Moving to the next question, this is what obtuse angle we have to find out, and two sides are given. So we can use here sine rule. A upon sine A is equals to B upon sine B is equals to C upon sine C. If triangle is like this, if this is A, this is A. If I am going to take this B, then B, and if C, then C, like this. So in this question, like I am going to do, but this question will solve in the next because of the time constant. You can see 1407. Let me try it. Sine 39, 12 upon sine x. So I will write here sine x is equals to 12 into sine 39 upon 8. So I'm going to write 12 into sine 39 divide by 8. Shift, signing, answer 7. Okay, so I think we'll solve it. You can solve it because of the time constraint. I will solve in the next question. Thank you for watching. Please wait for the second video. Have a good day.